Hi, I'm at the Green Room at the Mowgli and I play, which is happening at Palo Alto. It's a production of Natak, and I have here with me playwright and director of Mowgli and I with me, Mr. Agastya.
Hi. Nice to meet all of you. I'm Harish Agastya. Welcome to tonight's show of Mowgli and I.
Yes. So tell us something about Mowgli and I.
All right. So Mowgli and I is a play that's based on Rudyard Kipling's classic, The Jungle Book. That's of course a well-known play. A lot of theater groups do The Jungle Book itself. I felt there was an opportunity to go beyond The Jungle Book because, as our tagline goes, there's more to The Jungle Book than meets the eye. The original classic was written primarily targeted at kids. It's a fairly two-dimensional representation of the world where people are either purely good or purely bad. And largely the story is around the chief protagonist of the story, Mowgli. However, the backstories of the other characters, you know, Bagheera and Bhalu and Sher Khan, and you know how Mowgli grew up in a world where he was a misfit amongst wolves, a freak, if you will. None of that's really covered. So what I tried to represent in this story, in this play, is what I call a reimagining of the Jungle Book. So if we told it from the perspective of all the characters, as opposed to just Mowgli, we would have a better understanding of what were the motives, you know, that causes Bagheera and Sher Khan to be the individuals they are. One's a wildcat, the other's a wildcat too. One's Mowgli's best friend and the other is his arch enemy. Why is that? We explore that. Why is Bhalu, the bear, the teacher of wolf cubs? We try and understand that. So the play explores a lot about this. It's in a world where we're looking at anthropomorphizing characters, animal characters, and representing them as humans, we try and understand human traits in characters, right? The original story did that. We try and do that at a much deeper level.
And how did you get this idea? Like suddenly out of the blue, or were you thinking about this?
So I was, yes. Natak, I've been with Natak since we started the group in 95.
You're one of the founding members?
I wouldn't call myself a founder, but I was one of the first people to join the team. Mm-hmm. It was founded by basically Stanford and Berkeley students. Sujit Saraf, our artistic director, started the group. I was with him when the team was started, but it was really his brainchild. In the 40 productions that we have done over, we've done, this is our 40th play.
Wow.
And in the 39 plays we've done, we've not tackled this type of genre, this fantasy adventure, children's genre. Mm-hmm. So it was something that was on my bucket list, if you will, for a long time. And I thought this was a particularly interesting play because it's everyone's heard the story. They've all seen the movie. So it's very well known. Yet in all representations that we see, it's done primarily as kind of an American story. Disney is what comes first to mind. You think about, you know, the bare necessities of life and things like that. However, the story is set in India. So it really fits our group very well to take on this genre, to try and explore some of the things I talked about, yet present it as an Indian theater group, right? Looking at this play. So our play is the story is told in English. Mm-hmm. There are a couple of scenes, you know, so as I say, the story is in English because English is the language of the jungle. However, in a couple of scenes, the story moves beyond the jungle into the cities and villages of India. And there, the language spoken is the language of the region, which is Hindi.
A lot of scope for creativity there.
So we have a couple of scenes where the actors speak in Hindi and we have super titles in English.
So do you act as well?
That is one of my primary passions. I started the group doing that, but I have also directed. This is my fifth play I'm directing with Natak.
And which one has been the close, your favorite so far?
My favorite is Mowgli and I.
I was expecting that answer. And why so?
Well, this is definitely the biggest, grandest production we have attempted, I think, in Natak's history, and definitely mine. The sets, the costumes, the makeup, you know, the...
How many characters are there?
There is about 32 characters, but 22 actors playing that. So it's a very large cast, including 9 kids, original music, live singing on stage. A lot of these things we haven't done before. So it is, quite a challenge and adventure.
How difficult is it to direct adults as compared to kids?
Adults, trivially, adults are easier to work with because, you know, they're mature, they're, you know, they take direction really easily. I was a bit scared about what I was getting into with so many kids in the cast. And it is a challenge keeping them focused. But the other side of it is they are also sponges. They are the only group in this cast that know not just their lines, they know everyone else's lines. They just know it, not because they try to learn it, just they just absorb so much faster.
And they knew it 1 week in the practice. So it was very interesting because all the adults, of course, we had all kinds of other things going on in our life. But nevertheless, we are slow in memorizing our lines. And these kids were prompting us, oh, this is your line now, this is your line now. So that was a very different kind of experience that I had. Otherwise, you have prompters and things like that, and then you're stopping. But here, the kids are prompting you.
Wow. Do you want to introduce yourself? What are you playing?
I'm playing Balu the Bear. Yeah, my name is Nitin Deo. This is the second play I'm doing with Natak. The first one I did was Hindi. This one is English. I do Marathi plays with Kala. That's a different organization that does Marathi plays. But this is very interesting because initially when Harish started this, I wasn't so sure. It's like, you know, why Jungle Book? You know, why this? And it wasn't really coming together in my mind. But as things started gelling, it was so good. And you will see it on the stage that the music, the actors, the singing, the kids, the adult actors, the sets, the makeup, everything just comes together so beautifully. And this is a new, new level that Natak has reached. And the next director is going to have a tough time matching this performance.
Wow, I'm sure. What are you playing?
I'm playing Bagheera. My name is Sindhu Singh, and this is my third play with Natak. And it's been, I would say, an amazing experience working with Harish. And as far as the character itself, probably the most challenging thing for me and probably the thing that made me grow at the most as an actor was playing an animal. So how do you convincingly bring across the mannerisms, the walk, the look, the behavior of the animal to where it's not a caricature, but you can actually really feel like, okay, this is a panther I'm looking at. So it was actually Harish hired a movement coach, which is the first in Natak, to teach all the animals how they should be moving. A bhalu, for example, plods slowly and heavily.
My, how long have you guys been practicing?
We've been practicing for 12 weeks now. Yes, very intensely, probably about 5-6 rehearsals
like
a week.
Months.
Yeah. Our families have forgotten us.
I'm sure you're going to miss all this once it's over.
It's become a big family and we're just all talking about it today, how sad we are that this is our last show. And so, yeah, there's a lot of, warm feelings and goodwill that Harish has created along with his team. So
we have another protagonist here. Could you introduce yourself?
So no show is complete without the bad guy. So here's the bad guy.
That was Quaiden.
I'm Sher Khan. I won't let this kid survive. These two cats, this is the best friend of Mowgli and this is his worst nightmare.
Oh my God, already in your character. That was quite an entry.
This is 20 minutes before showtime. So we have to get ready. We have to get in the mood. This is the sixth show. 1,500 people, 1,200 people have watched, and now 300 people. Last 300 people, we have Consul General of India in San Francisco, Mr. N. Parthasarathy. He will be the chief guest today. So we are all psyched even more. My parents flew in from India. They are in the
audience. Oh my God, specially for this?
Yeah. And my daughter's debut with Natak. You know, Harish talked about how kids are getting involved for the first time. When Harish
and I. What is your daughter playing?
She's playing one of the monkeys. You will see. Yeah, so this is growing off Natak. When Harish and I started, we were bachelors, then we got married, and now we have 10 and 13-year-old kids.
That must be quite an emotional moment to enact with your daughter. How was it?
It's super, super awesome. You know, just, in addition to the rehearsal, just driving up to the rehearsal and driving back and talking about plays and what do you feel about it and rehearsing and giving tips to each other. Kids are amazing.
And wait till you see her. She's a brilliant performer. She's a complete diva. She's going to outdo her dad.
That will be a proud moment for you.
Every time she goes on stage, there is a little tear rolling down.
I'm sure.
By the way, Harish's son is also one of the monkeys.
Wow, so the whole family. It's a huge family here of actors. And is acting your passion, all of you?
Absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely.
I've been acting like a good husband all my life.
And I've been acting like a good employee all my life.
Thank you so much. That was great.
Let's very quickly introduce you to the other characters in this room, right? So this is Ka being made up right now. Ka is, of course, the python. And this is Archana Penukonda. So Archana Anaconda Penukonda. and over here we have Tabaki, the jackal. And she is the Shakuni, if you will, of our production, the wily jackal. And this is Soumya Agasta. She's our artistic designer. She's been responsible for all of the costume and makeup design and the general look and feel of the play. If we go over to the other room, I can give you a quick idea of who the other cast members are. So I just wanted to introduce you to the rest of the cast members in Mowgli and I. You'll see a lot of folks here in the back. Those are my wolves. They are the serenading wolves here, and they sing, they act, they dance, they move scenery. There's a number of them, and this is not the entire team. We also have over here in orange and red the Bandar Log. These are some of the kids in my cast. There's six of them. All of them are not here at this time. We have my Mowglis. Where are my Mowglis? This is little Mowgli right here. And then the older Mowgli is in makeup right now, Samay Dubey. He's one of the leads in the play, and you'll see him on stage in a bit. And who else is here that I haven't introduced? Sonali Dipali, they're monkeys. They are also city girls in the play. I think that kind of covers. Oh, and Jungli right here. Jungli, we'll know about him and who he is as the play unfolds. The play begins with Jungli. He's like a homeless guy in the cities of India. His lines are all in Hindi.
Say some of the lines if you can. Yeah! Mat mare!
One more.
Once more, the same scream. Are you sure? Are you wanted as homeless as ever? Hum jungli nahi hu. Hum jungle se hu, par hum jungli nahi hu. We keep going.
You're too good. Thank you.
So that was, I guess, I gave you an idea of all the cast members. In addition, Pradeep Gupta, he's over there in the front of the stage. He's our producer. He's helped design and create a lot of the sets that you'll see on stage. Nishant Asthana is our music composer. He composed all of the Western songs. We have Sharvari Dixit right here, and Sharvari, right now she's in makeup, part of the makeup team, but she is also the person who composed the Hindi folk song that you'll see here in the play. So that kind of gives you, I think...
That was a wonderful introduction, and you have an amazing cast here. Thank you so much for introducing us to all of them. Thank you, Harish.
Thank you so much.
Wish you good luck. I'm sure the show will be a grand success, the finale.
I look forward to it. I hope you enjoy the show. Take your seats.
Thank you.
Makeup artist.
The one who was doing the makeup?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll come there. Yeah.
I'll do a different one.
Good. Anything you want. Anything.
I have a dream that one day monkeys everywhere will learn from their human cousins like you have and find inner peace.
Wow.
Wait a minute. Take that back. I mean, how can you call this a humble residence? If you compare it to those dumps the other jungle people live in, this is more of a palace, actually.
You kids are super talented. How old are you?
I'm 10.
12.
11.
11.
Oh my god, so much talent at this young age. Do you want to say a line?
Sure. Mowgli, what they are all trying to say is, the Bandar Log are the best
best of the jungle peoples. But to seek true greatness, we seek something. A missing link that impedes our evolution from intelligent apes to intelligent humans.
Amazing. Is this your first time acting or?
This is my first time.
First time?
Yeah, it's my first time ever doing this, something like this. I've never acted before. This is my first play. I think it went well. It was pretty fun and I want to do it again.
And what motivated you? Did somebody tell you about this play? Or how did you get started?
Well, Rithvik and I, we've like known each other for a long time, and Rithvik, like, he always knew about his dad being acting. And when, at a really young age, we kept on like doing weird skits whenever they came over and stuff. And then this year, over the summer, my mom said, "Harsh Uncle is having people audition for a play. Would you be interested?" And I'm like, "Okay, sure."
Nice. How about you? First time?
Yeah, it's my first time with Natak. I've done like school plays and stuff before, but those were mandatory, so yeah.
Are you enjoying? Did you have fun?
Yeah. So I heard about Natak because Somi Uncle Jungly,
the homeless street bum,
acted in a different play that my parents went to, and then they got on the mailing list for Natak, and so then when the audition emails came in, I decided to audition.
Cool story. How about you?
This is my first ever play.
Did you enjoy it?
Yeah, it was really fun. So my dad, he's been with Natak for almost for as long as it has been existing. So then I've always watched his plays. I really like them. And then when I heard that Harish Uncle was doing a play with the kids, I really wanted to audition.
Cool. Are you Mowgli? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. How was it playing the protagonist?
Good. Mm-hmm. I had lots of fun and I made lots of friends.
You're going to miss it once it's over?
Yeah.
I'm happy to do this play, be in this play, and when my dad over there told me about it, I got really excited. And I knew that I really wanted to do the play because there were monkeys in the play. So, and I thought it would be a really good role for me.
You remember long back in 2009,
Yudhavya, right? Hi, Somya. So, how are you involved with the play?
So, I've been involved with Natak since 1996 as well. I've acted in a couple of plays and also been involved in the sets, mm-hmm. and also have produced two plays. So I've always done a lot of the backside, like carpentry and sets and design and costumes and makeup.
Your contribution to Mowgli and I?
So it's mainly all the costumes that you've seen. So design them, and also we stitch them, and we have a team. And also,
wow, those animal costumes and everything, how long did it take?
So we've been... Or at least we've been thinking about it since May of this year. And then when I went to India, I did some sketches and kind of bought some of the fur, like the Bhalu fur, the Sher Khan fur, all are from India. And then we bought other furs over here. And then most of it is hand-stitched, actually. So we have like 3-4 of us who just stitched the whole thing. We wanted to keep the cost low. So that is one of the main things.
So do you have a team of volunteers helping you out with this?
Yes. So we are 4 of us. Monica, Uma, and Vishalini. So we 4 of us actually stitch most of these costumes.
What was your favorite part during the practice, and some special memory?
Special memory is the car. I love the car costume and the makeup, because we had to go to Home Depot, try to figure out something which had to coil around and stay in perfect in shape with all the movements. So that was a challenging one, and something that it'll remain in my memory for the rest of it.
Which was the most difficult character to paint, to get makeup and everything?
Sher Khan was the most complicated.
How long did it take? It
takes around 20-25 minutes. The first time it took like 40 minutes, and right now we've come down to 20 minutes.
Practice?
By practice, yes. 50% cut down.
Okay. Sounds good. Thank you so much for talking to us.
Thank you very much.
We have the Council General of India here with me, Mr. Partha Sarthy. Thank you so much for talking to us. How are you enjoying the show?
It's wonderful.
Is this your first time watching a Natak play?
No, it's amazing. I've been here for 1 year. In 1 year, they have put up 3 shows, and this is the third. And I have seen the both earlier ones, and I'm enjoying the third one now.
How different is this one from the other two?
It is definitely different, but it's also difficult to put it on stage. because there are so many technical difficulties to bring it on, and there are so many children involved, and there's so much, but I'm really enjoying it because it's beautifully done.
Right. What is your favorite part?
At this moment, the monkey show.
The Bandar Log?
Bandar show. That is beautiful, and particularly if you look at the children, you see, if you know the technicalities, many a times when you have that microphone and when you have to speak, it picks up the echo. So it's not easy. You'll have to be located in a particular place. The way they did, the way they delivered the dialogue, and the whole show, the coordination, it's fantastic.
I was amazed at so much talent at such young age, the kids.
Exactly. And not only that, don't forget, all those who are acting, they are all working. At the same time, they will have to find the time, they have to have this creativity, and they have to do that. That's what makes you feel proud and enjoy the whole thing. It's wonderful.
It's so great they're pursuing their passion. I mean, I've interviewed a couple of them, and everybody, acting is my passion.
That's true. That's what you have to have, something creative, something to do. And that they are doing it so wonderfully. And the most interesting thing is, we have seen plays in India, but coming out and seeing one and seeing the level of maturity and acting of this quality, I think that's what is very, very appreciable.
Now I really want to ask, what is your passion? What do you enjoy the most?
I also, three decades back, I used to be acting, and I used to be in the film,
wow,
the stage. But now, of course, we write and we do all other things.
So now you're too busy.
Yes, it's too busy. I mean, now it's more interesting to keep participating in these events and encouraging them. That's our thing.
Thank you so much for supporting all the community events. Thank you. It was wonderful talking to you.
Pleasure. Thank you. Thank you.